So you're looking for the best system.io review? Well, pay close attention because we're about to jump right into it. All right, so the first plan is the free plan, right? And that is not a trial. That is a completely free plan until you hit a certain limit. Now, what is that limit? As you can see right here, you could build a list of 2,000 people for free. And then right here, you can have a blog for free, membership sites for free, automation workflows for free. So that's dealing with like your email marketing. And then if we look around here, you can have one-click upsells for free, order bumps for free, A/B testing. So like if you want to split test certain pages for free. And then if you look here, like if you're doing like your product or something like that and you want to give coupon codes, you can actually do that for free. And then custom domains, like if you want to connect one of your domains that you already own, that's for free as well. And then down here, the only thing that's not free is the evergreen webinar. So if you want to do like webinars and stuff like that, then you're going to have to go with the first premium plan, which I believe is the $27 a month, but we'll see here in a minute. So marketplace offers, that is also not free. Now let's go back up, right? So the $27 per month plan, it gives you a whole lot more, right? You can build a list of up to 5,000 people with this for only $27 a month. You're also going to be able to build up to 10 pages. You can have 5 blogs, membership sites. You can also have 5. Automation and rules, pretty much everything you get over here, but of course it continues to go up as the price continues to go up, right? This is everything, including the webinar, right? So you're getting all of this, plus you're being able to build a list of 10,000 people on your list and only pay $47 a month. And then we can see the top plan, which is the enterprise, $97 a month, right? Like I said, this is free. So you can use the first link in the description if you want to get started with this and start building out your business. But what I'm about to do now is I'm about to show you exactly how to build a sales funnel from scratch with this. All right, so when you first log in, this is exactly what it's going to look like, right? So you come in and then if you want to start building out your sales funnel, what you want to do is you want to come up here to where it says sales funnels. Once you come here, you want to go right here to where it says create, click that, and then you want to go ahead and name your funnel, right? So I'm gonna just name mine's test. And then right here, you can see I got my funnel domain right now. If you haven't yet connected your domain, I'll create another video showing exactly how you can go about doing that, right? But for now, I'm gonna just go ahead and use that. And then I'm gonna click build an audience, right? You can go with sale or custom or evergreen webinar, but just for sake of this video, we're gonna use build an audience. All right, so now what it does is it brings me in here where I can pretty much choose a template. Okay, so let's just roll with this one right here. All right, I'm gonna show you how simple this is. So once you actually choose a template, over here you can see you got your squeeze page, you got your thank you, right? So if you click that, then you can choose the thank you page that you want to go with. And then of course you can add a step, right? So if I wanted to, all I would do is I would hit create step and then boom, I would name that and then I would go throughout that process, right? But I'm not going to do that in this video, but that's just something, you know, just for you. All right, so let's go back to the squeeze page real quick. So once you get on this page, you can come over here and depending on what it is, right? Because when I do this stuff, I like to be real organized just so I know exactly what everything is. So if it's an ebook that I'm going to have on my squeeze page, I want to put ebook or whatever the name of the ebook is. If it's a video series, I'm going to actually put video series, right? So I'll just show you exactly what I'm talking about. All right, so if I know that this is a video series and I know that's what they're opting in for, then that this lets me know what it is that I need to know. All right, so now the next step is we want to click right here on this little edit page, all right? Click that. And then it's gonna open up the page, all right? So we can see this is how the page looks right here. The 3-step system to sell on autopilot. Now I did a video here on my channel teaching you how to write effective headlines to create capture pages that actually convert. So I'll link that video down below in the description. You could check it out. It's going to teach you how to do exactly what I'm about to do. All right. Now, typically when I create my capture pages, I use this right here, right? I say free video reveals. It's kind of like my favorite thing to do depending on what it is, right? So if it's a cheat sheet, then I'm going to say free cheat sheet reveals or free ebook reveals or free report, whatever it is, right? And then I'm going to say something like how to do this without this. So typically, how to get whiter teeth in 7 days, even if you drank coffee 3 times per day, right? That's just an example of what you could do when it comes to like creating your landing pages. All right, so let me see. I'm gonna just write something. How to make money from home even if you never, I don't know. We're just going to leave it like that right now. Make sure you don't do yours like that. But I didn't really think about this, you know, really going into this. But this is just what you want to have as your headline. Now, what you can do if you don't like that, you can hit bold on that to make it like that. Or you can click over here. You'll see in a minute. So if I map this orange around, you want to make sure that this orange is around it. And then you want to click this little conig right here. Now over here, I can mess with the size of this, right? I can make it real big if that's what I want to do. And then I can change the line height and all of that good stuff, right? Now let's say, for instance, I don't like the font. I'm going to click right here and I'm going to be like, all right, let's see. Web safe fonts. Let's try that. And then let's go with Arial Helvetica, right? So you see how it pretty much just changed. So literally you can mess with everything on this page, right? It really doesn't matter. Now over here, you see these elements. So let's say, for instance, you want to put a video on your page, right? I could literally drag this over here, put a video on top if that's what I want to do. And boom, you see the video went in there. Now, what I like about their video is it doesn't have to be from an actual platform. Let me show you what I mean. So if I click on the conig right here and I come over here, it says video type. When I click that, you can see it says YouTube custom embed, upload file and direct link. So literally, if I wanted to upload a file from my computer, I could literally upload a file right to this system. That's pretty powerful. I really haven't seen that on many systems, and I've used a lot of different systems out there. So I think that's pretty cool. All right. So that's something that you could do, or you can go back to whatever element you want to add. Right. So you can add an image. You can add audio. You could do a carousel. You can add different columns to the page, right? You can really customize this, which is pretty cool, right? So let's say, for instance, right, this is the page that you want to create. What you want to do is you want to actually connect this page to your email autoresponder. So how do you do that? So what we want to do, right, is we want to click on the button. And then from the button, you see right here, it says, once we click the button, then over here, it says action when button click. You hit send form, all right? So now you got a couple options. You can either do a pop-up. So as soon as they click that button, a little pop-up it'll just like pop up and then they can put their email in. But that wouldn't make sense on this page because the email is already exposed, right? Now imagine if it was just a button on this page, then it would make sense for you to do like a two-step funnel to where when they click it, boom, then it pops up and then they can put their email in. But for sake of this video, we just gonna use send form. Now, right here it says, do you want to redirect users after contact registration? So what I wanna do is I want it to go to the next step, which was what we showed you on the page, and we're gonna go back there in a few minutes. But at this point, the only thing we will wanna do is just change the words. So depending on whatever it is that I'm gonna be sending them, so if I'm gonna be sending them a cheat sheet, then what I wanna do is I wanna do something like this. Give me my cheat sheet, right? Because they feel like, hey, it's my cheat sheet. So give me my cheat sheet. So I'll put something like this, and I've actually done this and it works pretty well actually, right? So you could do that. And then if it's not big enough for you, all you got to do is just make it bigger. As you can see, it's changing right there. Very, very simple. All right. So at this point, what I want to do, right, you can go into the settings real quick. I want to say it's over. Okay. So right here, let's say if you're more advanced, right? Maybe you're doing like Facebook ads or Google ads or anything like that, or Bing ads. And if you want to like use code on your site, what you could do is you can edit the header code right down here, paste your Facebook pixel in there, your Google tag or whatever it is, and then literally hit save and then you'll be good to go. Right? Very, very simple, right? So you can really do a lot with this. Just think about it. It's a free system, especially if you don't have 2,000 leads right now. You could be leveraging this system to build up to where you can get to a point to where you're actually making money, all right? So now the next step is I want to choose what thank you page do I want, right? So when I go over here, the only one that makes sense, especially like for a lead magnet, is to just give people like straight up directions. All right. So if I click on this one right here, this one is very, very straight up, right? So I'm going to click edit page real quick. And then over here, boom. So if I was sending them an ebook, boom, I just put the color. I just put the ebook right there so they can see what it is that they're going to receive in their inbox. And then I can literally change the directions to what I want them to say. So if I don't want it to say, check your email inbox, I can say, hey, check your messenger, or hey, check this instead. But as long as they have those directions, they're good to go, right? So it makes the process a whole lot simpler, all right? So we got this page, we know what they're gonna get. This is the page that they're gonna come to, and then it's gonna be sent over to their email. However it is that you set up your process, right? I just kinda wanna walk you through, you know, rather briefly here in this video. All right, so now the next step is I wanna hit save changes. And then I'm just going to go ahead and hit exit on this. Boom. I got my squeeze page set up. I also got my, and I'll give you a preview real quick. So this right here, if I click on this, it's going to show me my funnel that I just built. Boom. Free video reveals how to make money from home. Even if you never, of course you don't want to use something like that, but that's just to show you how it works, right? Boom. My page is ready to go. And we're ready to rock and roll. Now, the next step in the process is to actually set up an email. And I'm about to show you exactly how to do that. So what we want to do is we want to go up here to the drop down arrow. We want to click campaigns. Now, I'm already there, but it's going to bring you to this page like this. So the next step is you want to go up here to the blue button. You want to click create. Now, it's going to tell you to name the campaign. Go ahead and name your campaign specific to what it is that you're going to be talking about. So for me, I'm just going to use test. You don't have to worry about a description. Go ahead and hit save campaign. All right, so it created the campaign. So what you want to do next is click right here on the hyperlink of the name of the campaign. So click that, and then now up here it says add an email. And then right here, you see it says sender name, Rakeem Addison, and sender email address, system@rakeemaddison.com. So it's very important that you don't use a Gmail email here because you're gonna have deliverability issues, all right? It's important that, and I'll just tell you what I did. I used my domain that I already own, and I created a forward email. And then as you can see, all I had to do, of course, there are steps behind this, but this is what it ended up being, system@rakeemaddison.com. So the whole point of this is to increase your deliverability rate, right? Because there's something with like DMARC and, DKIM, and this lets people know that it's actually coming from you. Okay, so that's the whole point of that, all right? So make sure, and I may put together a video that walks you through actually setting that process up, because it is a couple of steps, all right? So I just let you know what that is, all right? All right, so now subject line, all right? So I'm gonna just roll with top marketing strategies no one uses, and then I'm gonna go with classic editor. All right, so now I'm gonna hit create. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna say, hey, and let's say for instance, a person went to the capture page and you were actually collecting the name and the email, then what you could do to make it more personal is you could use a substitute. All right, so I'm gonna copy that right there. And then let's say for instance, I wanted to say their name. I'm gonna just copy this and it's gonna say, hey, and it's gonna fill in their name automatically. And as you can see, it's a couple different ones you could use over here, email, city, country, phone number. It's whatever it is that you're collecting on the actual capture page, all right? All right, so now if we scroll down, let's just act as if we're about to try to finish this email. Let's just say, learn from a pro. Obviously you wouldn't be writing that whack email. I'm just telling you, you know, just showing you how the whole process works, all right? All right, so now let's look up here. You see where it says attachments. You can actually add an attachment as well directly from the computer. The same, just like when I was showing you how to set up the sales funnel, where you could actually add a video directly from your computer, not relying on the actual platforms like YouTube and Vimeo and etc. All right, so now the next part, we got our email, good to go. Let's say for instance, you want to put a affiliate link in there. You say something like, this training, right? So I'm gonna say this training, and then let's say for instance I wanted to put it right there. I would copy this first, and then I will click on this little link thing, and I'm gonna use www.google.com real quick just for sake of this video. And then boom, learn from a pro, this training. And then all I have to do next is I have to send a test email. So I'm gonna hit save and send a test email. Okay, this email has been sent successfully to the email that I set up, right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go check my email to make sure it actually came through. Okay, boom, there it is. It's 513 right now and it's 513 up here. There's the exact email I just created. Hey, first name, learn from a pro this training. Now, the reason it says first name because it's a test email. But if it was the actual email, it'll actually put their name because they would be coming through the actual sales funnel. So now what I have to do is I have to go to automations and I have to create a rule because we need to connect the sales funnel and this email. All right, so over here, what I'm gonna do, and actually I'm gonna go back to the sales funnel itself, click on this test funnel, and then what I have to do right here where it says automation rules, I'm gonna click on that, and then I'm gonna add a rule within the funnel I just created. So first you wanna click on funnel step form subscribe, and then you wanna add an action, all right? So I'm gonna add an action, and I'm gonna hit subscribe to the campaign. So as soon as they put their name and their email into the capture page, it's then gonna register. Okay, this is the next step in the process. So I'm gonna hit subscribe to the campaign. And then right here, I'm gonna choose the campaign that I just created. That's why it was important for you to create the campaign first and then set the rule up so you can connect the whole thing together. All right, so I'm gonna click test because that was the campaign I created, and I'm gonna hit save rule. So at this point, literally, I just set up the entire sales funnel and the email sequence. So as soon as a person comes, puts their name and email in there, it'll send the email just like how I just showed you in my email. It's gonna send the email to them. So hopefully you got some value from this video. And if you did, definitely go ahead and give me a thumbs up. Also, drop me a comment down below with any additional questions that you have. And if you're ready to get started with systemeio today, go ahead and use the first link down below in the description box. That'll allow you to get started instantly. Now, with that being said, I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Peace.